Hello, everyone, and welcome to Little World Shakers Live. I am Mrs. Abby, and I have the pleasure of sharing an amazing story with you guys today. If it's your first time, don't be shy. Be sure to let us know where you're watching from, how you heard about us. Share your name in the comments next to me, and we cannot wait to meet you. If you are new, I want to remind you, or inform you, better yet, to stay until the end and be sure to click the link provided in the comments section to follow us into our Zoom after party. Right after this story, we gather together, get to see each other's face in our Zoom after party. You don't want to miss it, so be sure to stick around to the end. Now, all through September, we have been celebrating friendship. We celebrated and decided to have a Little World Shakers block party where all of you and everyone else is invited, purely because we believe friendship is so worth celebrating. What is friendship? Friendship is showing people we care through our words and actions. Now you, Little World Shakers, took it a step further and decided to participate in our monthly challenge. This month, we asked you guys to create a card and put sticky notes on it to create a positive message to anyone you felt like bringing the card to, hopefully essential workers. I am amazed at what you guys have done. Check out these cool clips of the cards you Little World Shakers created. This was cool. Wasn't that so cool? I'm so proud of all of you for participating. The more we join together, the more love we spread, the more light we spread, the more we get to share God's love and be friends to others. Now, I really want to encourage you to follow our Instagram at Little World Shakers for all of our new updates. You can also download the app, congregation.family app, and all of our updates are also on the app. Be sure to check out our monthly challenges, our monthly memory verse, where you guys can memorize a Bible verse each month with us. There's so many ways to get involved. Be sure to follow us on these social media platforms and don't miss out on the fun. Are you ready for story time? Okay, it's gonna be a good one as we close up this month on friendship. Now, God's love means we are forgiven and we're free. But does that mean our lives are gonna be perfect now? Not exactly. There are gonna be times in life that we get hurt. And when we get hurt in our heart, it's really tough. Imagine you have a friend who's having a party and all your other friends get invited, but you don't. That can cause you some pain. Imagine you say something hurtful to your friend and you didn't mean it, but in the moment it slipped. Now your friend's heart is hurt. What do you do now? Well, just like a Band-Aid, just like medicine helps heal our bodies, God has given us a way to heal our hearts. God has given us the gift of forgiveness. Forgiveness allows us to heal our heart so that we can be nice and kind and loving to people. Now, in the moment that we feel hurt, we can look to a story in the Bible of two men, Jesus and Peter, and really look at how Jesus forgave Peter. It's a wonderful story that teaches us how we can forgive and really get our heart back to the right condition. Now, as I tell you the story, I'm gonna pause and take some breaks and ask you a question. When I ask you the question, it'll pop up on the screen with options A, B, C, or D. Now, I would love when you guys participate. So be sure to put in the chat box what you think the answer is when I ask you, what do you think comes next? Okay? I want this to be fun, but it's only fun when we're all participating together. Okay? All right, so be close to your keyboards and I want you to really jump in on this story. Ready? Here we go. Peter was one of Jesus' disciples and he was also a brave follower of Jesus. But Peter sometimes said things without thinking. He makes mistakes, just like all of us do. The night before Jesus was put on trial and was going to be killed, Peter promised Jesus that he loved him and that he would always stick by him. He promised Jesus he would follow him. He even told Jesus he would give up his life for him. But that evening, when Jesus was arrested, Peter told people he didn't even know Jesus because he was so scared. Okay, get ready to type. How many times do you think Peter said that he didn't know Jesus? Is it A, 1, B, 2, C, 3, or D, 1 million? Nice job. For those of you who voted C, you're right. Peter told three different people he didn't know Jesus. Now, you can imagine Jesus was probably really hurt by that because Peter told Jesus he would follow him and he would even give his life for him. That meant Jesus could really trust Peter. But when things got tough, Peter betrayed Jesus. He claimed he didn't even know him. But as you probably guess, that's not the end of this Jesus story. Jesus came back to life after he was killed. And he even went and visited his friends to prove that he was alive. Jesus was probably feeling the pain, but he still was practicing forgiveness. Now, Peter was probably excited, but at the same time, scared. He was probably wondering if Jesus was mad at him. Was he still Jesus' friend? Did Jesus still love him? Not long after Jesus came back to life, Peter and some friends were fishing on the Sea of Galilee. They were out all night and hadn't caught anything. Now, in the early morning hours, they saw someone standing on the shore. Who do you think they saw? A, a sea captain, B, Jesus, C, King Herod, or D, Peter's mom? If you voted B, you're right. It was Jesus, but the men didn't realize it was him at first. And then Jesus called out to them with instructions. Let's see what he said. I'm reading in my Bible from the book of John chapter 21, verse 5 through 6. Here's what Jesus said. He called out to them, "Friends, don't you have any fish?" "No," they answered. He said, "Throw your net on the right side of the boat. Then you will find some fish." When the men did as the stranger instructed, they filled their net with so many fish they couldn't even pull the net into the boat. Then John realized that the stranger was Jesus, and he told Peter. Peter got so excited, he threw on his coat and jumped into the water to swim to Jesus. All the disciples followed with the net full of fish in the boat and went to meet Jesus. When they got to the shore and they found Jesus, Jesus had been preparing a breakfast for all of them. Now, get ready to type. What do you think Jesus was preparing for them for breakfast? Was it A, Cheerios, B, pancakes, C, French toast, or D, fish and bread? Yes, that's right. D is the correct answer. Jesus had prepared a breakfast for them with fish and bread. In fact, he even told them to share the fish they caught because they had so many. John even wrote down how many fish they caught. Now, get ready to type. How many fish do you think the men caught? Is it A, 153, B, 365, C, 525,600, or D, 1 million? Yes, the answer is A. The men had caught 153 fish with Jesus' help. Now, Jesus prepared this breakfast for them. He sat and ate with them. He made this lovely meal out of fish and bread. When they were done eating, Jesus walked and talked with Peter. Peter was probably worried because, remember, he claimed he didn't know Jesus not once, not twice, but three times. Okay, get ready to type. What do you think Jesus said to Peter? Is it A, I forgive you? B, do you know who I am? C, feed my lambs? D, Peter, how could you? Those are some good guesses. Let's see what Jesus says to Peter by reading it in the book of John. Now, remember, Peter also has another name known as Simon. Okay, I'm reading from John chapter 21, verse 15 through 17. It says, Jesus asked, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than the others do? Yes, Lord, he answered, you know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my lambs. Again, Jesus asked, Simon, son of John, do you love me? He answered, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said, take care of my sheep. Jesus spoke to him a third time. He said, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter felt bad because Jesus asked him a third time, do you love me? He answered, Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my sheep. For all of you who guessed C, you were right. Jesus said, feed my lambs and feed my sheep. Now that might seem a little bit confusing, so let's see what Jesus meant by sheep and lambs. Here's the next question. When Jesus said, feed my lambs, what was he talking about? Is it A, his pet lambs? B, the lambs at the Nazareth Zoo? C, his pet fish? Or D, his followers? If you guessed D, you were right. By lambs, Jesus meant his followers. He was telling Peter to look after his people, to look after the people who followed Jesus. In fact, it was so important to Jesus that he told Peter three times. Let's look what Jesus said in John chapter 21, verse 19. Then Jesus told Peter what was coming, that Peter would dedicate his life to following Jesus. He told Peter, follow me. Jesus forgave Peter so completely that he gave him the job of looking after all of his followers and the people who would later learn about Jesus. That's a big deal. You see, when Jesus forgave Peter, he made sure Peter knew that they were good again, that he wasn't mad at him. Peter didn't have to guess, man, is Jesus upset with me? Are we cool? Can I hang out with Jesus? Jesus let Peter know, I forgive you. And he gave him a huge job. Now, just as Jesus forgave Peter and God forgives us, we have to forgive our friends. Because friends forgive each other. Even though we love our friends, forgiving isn't always easy. When they've hurt us and they've caused us some kind of pain, it's not easy to just forgive them. But God can help us to forgive. Let's ask God to help us right now. Dear God, thank you for the gift of forgiveness. Thank you for showing us over and over again how to forgive our friends. Thank you, God, for using the story of Jesus forgiving Peter so many times, God. Help us to forgive our friends like Jesus forgave Peter. And help us, God, to forgive our friends just like you forgive us over and over again. I pray, God, that all of us, even when it's challenging, can learn from this story, God, to be forgiving. And I pray that our friends forgive us, too, when we mess up. We're not always going to get it right, God. But help us when you know what we need. Give us the right tools to forgive our friends and to have forgiveness in our friendships. We thank you for this day. I pray for everyone watching. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, it's time. If you have your wise eyes, join with me and put your wise eyes on. Now, friendship can have tough seasons. Maybe you have a disagreement from time to time. But when you forgive your friend, you save a friendship. Say that with me. Friends forgive one another. Friends forgive one another. Now, I get it. If your friend made plans with you and all of a sudden cancels and you were looking forward to it, I get how that can make you upset. I also get what it feels like when friends leave you out. And then they show you or tell you how much fun they had without you. That could really hurt too. Let's say your friend accidentally hits you and you get so upset you don't even want to talk to them. You don't even give them a chance to apologize or to explain what actually happened. We don't want to be the friend that stays mad. Because if we stay mad, especially over things that are really small, even though they hurt, then we miss out on opportunities to create great memories together with our friends. Don't let one bad experience ruin a friendship. You can even forgive if the other person doesn't ask for your forgiveness. That doesn't mean you'll be best friends right away, but it allows for your heart to heal. It allows for you to let go of anger. It allows for you to have friendships. And the truth is, maybe the next time you might be the one hoping your friend forgives you. And when you forgive, you treat others the way you want to be treated. We're all gonna make mistakes. But when we forgive others, we allow others to forgive us. Now, I want to really highlight something important right now. Forgiveness is important, but if someone keeps hurting you or mistreating you and making you feel bad, it's important that you get another perspective. Ask mom and dad. Ask Mrs. Abby. Ask Mrs. Fredelin. Ask Mrs. Tammy. Ask Mrs. Felicia. We are all here to help you guys in friendships. Sometimes we don't have the answers. I've had times where someone made me feel bad and I have to call somebody like Pastor Paige and say, hey, I don't like the way this person made me feel. What do you think? And sometimes you have to take a little time off from people. But if they are hurting you and making you feel bad, it's important that you know you have adults you can go to and talk to and get advice from. None of you are alone. We don't want you to be in pain and to have others hurting you. And all it takes sometimes is just for each of you to share what's happening with an adult. And we got your back. We're here for you. I loved celebrating friendship with all of you in the month of September. I hope you all had a blast too. There is no party like a Little World Shakers party. Now, let's head into this Zoom after party and continue our final day of friendship celebration. We got more fun planned for you. Join me, click the link now, and remember, Little World Shakers, keep shaking up the world one step at a time. And before I forget, if you haven't already participated in the monthly challenge, hashtag pick a post-it, be sure to make a card and add post-its with positive affirmations, with positive notes to a hospital, to a grocery store, to any business, even your neighbor. Be a giver. Let's serve and spread God's love together. You still have time. We have half of this week coming up before September is over and we move into a new monthly challenge. So be sure to participate. You can even make a second one if you've already done one. And thank you, thank you, thank you. You Little World Shakers are givers. We help people out, okay? Be sure to send me your pictures and videos. I love to see you guys in action. All right, I'll see you in the Zoom after party.